Hey everybody, welcome back to Parkitect Disneyland. As you know, I've now completed the main street and I'm going to move on now to build the hub. Now the hub is quite a common thing that they do in Disneyland parks. It is basically a central hub for the park, then it spokes off and all the different lands are around the hub. Very common in Magic Kingdom style theme parks. So I'm just going to go ahead and plop down really roughly the shape and the size of my hub for the park. And I am gonna cut out quite a lot of what I did because it's very boring laying down path covers, and you've seen me do it many times before, so you know how I do it. So there we go, there's how it looks now. I'm just gonna pop a moat around it before I move on to building the Disney castle. The hub here is not finished, it's just very basic and a rough layout of how it will be. And I do go down and lay down the tram tracks around the whole thing. I didn't want to film that either because you've seen me do that in the main street laying down the tram track, so you know also how I did that. Very easy, I just used the fences from Shy Guys 4 and sunk them in the ground. So I'm just propping out basically the height and where the castle will go and just kind of looking up back and forward from a reference photo. I looked up a few castles just to get an idea, and my favourite one was the Disney Paris castle. It's the most cartoony looking, and the colors are obviously quite bright, so that's what I liked about it. I do like the Shanghai one as well, but I didn't think that one really fitted into this style part that I'm doing. So I'm basically just starting off with doing the front. I've never built a castle before, so this is my first castle, or like a princess type of castle anyway. And it's not something I'm familiar with, and it is something that I did find quite difficult, but I did really enjoy doing it, and it's definitely something that I was looking forward to doing because, as you know, that Disney use something called forced perspective, where it makes you think the castle was actually bigger than it is by making everything at the top a lot smaller than it is at the bottom. And that is something that I wanted to just have a go at in the game, even if it doesn't come across that way. I thought it'd be really cool to try and make all the turrets near the top of the castle a lot smaller than the ones near the bottom. So I've just added in a few details. I'm not going to keep in all the footage, otherwise this video will be about an hour long, which it was about an hour long, so I've had to really edit down. But basically what happens is I built the castle and I semi-complete it, and then I take a step back and I look at it and then I realise it's too small. So then I had to basically delete the whole thing and do it again, which was a bit of a pain, but I'm glad that I redid it, otherwise I would have been not happy with this castle. So that's the front of it now nearly complete. I want to add in the square tree style that Disney Paris has. I really love that. They have all these square trees, round little bushes and things all up along the front, and it really gives it that fantasy style. So I've tried to include that. And I think the square trees in the game actually really fit what I'm going for really well. I've not actually used these square trees before because I'm not the biggest fan of using them as a normal tree. But for the fantasy look, I think they're great. So this is when I start going in and actually building the castle. This is the first attempt, and basically I'm just using a picture from Disney Paris and just trying to match the colours up as best as I can and trying to capture some of the styles in. So they have these blue roofs and these pink walls, and they use like a gold trim along the roof pieces. So that's basically how the castle looks now. I'm just gonna copy each piece that I've used in it over to the side here to make building it again a lot easier, so I can just go over there and select the piece I want with the tool picker. So once I've laid all those pieces down, I will delete the castle, there we go. And then I'm gonna go back in now and just make everything that little bit bigger. The castle did look, I was really happy with it and I did like how it turned out. But when I zoomed out and I compared the size of the castle to the main street, it was so small and I thought, I mean, it had to be bigger. I know that the Disney California castle is actually quite small, but that's not what I was going for in this one. So I'm starting off with just doing the main turret up the middle, which will be the biggest one. A lot of this castle was actually trial and error. I was looking at the pictures and just trying to get like a general shape of the castle. So having the kind of the turrets in the right places, and then all the bits in between, I've just joined it up and just tried to make it neat and tidy and match. There is no kind of logic to this castle with rooms inside or anything like that. It's just literally a facade and just random pieces plopped down to try and make the general shape. So I did actually plan on making this a two-part video with the castle because it is so long, but I've decided just to cut it down and cram it all into one video because I did want to kind of get the castle done in one episode. So that is why this episode is actually a little bit longer than normal. Normally I do videos around about 10 to 12 minutes and this one is about 17, but I do get a lot done, so I guess that's the main thing. So in the one of the recent updates of Parkitect, they included these resizable shapes, and one of them is a cone and is perfect for the rooftops on the turrets for this castle. And unfortunately, when I was building this castle, those pieces weren't actually in the game yet. So I do go back and actually add those in. But for now, I actually use a square turret, which was a part of the brick wall set, which makes do for now. But I do go back and I actually think I include some little footage at the end of me changing them over to the round ones, which do look a lot better. The round shape definitely flows a lot more with the shape of the round turrets. So here I'm just using a pipe and vent set. There's a really large pipe in that set and I've used that as smaller turrets on the side. Obviously they're not functional, a person wouldn't fit in that, but from the ground looking up they definitely may give the illusion of forced perspective and that the castle is very tall and getting smaller and smaller towards the top. And instead of trying to use a roof piece, I've just used a piece of it's like a chimney piece from the details from the in-game set, and I've used that as a roof turret. I think sometimes using things to look like things is really okay if it gives the general image across. Like you can see that that is a roof compared to the other ones. They are smaller and that's what I wanted to go for. There isn't actually a roof piece that small, so kind of had to go with those pieces, but I think they look fine. And as you can see, also the square roofs there on top of each turret, they do look a bit odd now actually that I've seen them round. So when I do them round, they make a lot more sense. So at the moment, the castle is kind of flat, it's very bland, it's all one color. So I'm just gonna go through and add in some of these white kind of lines just to kind of break it up and give it more of a style. And then once I've done that, I will add the gold trims on all the roof pieces. That definitely kind of makes this castle stand out and give it a lot more character. It's funny sometimes how just a little thing like a gold trim on a roof can really make a difference in a building. I did actually have trouble with the backside of the castle. I've never really seen the backside of one. I have been to Disneyland, Paris and Florida, and obviously I've seen the back of the castles, but it's not really something that you remember. You always remember the front of them with the bridge and the gate and you go through. And so doing the back for me, and also there wasn't many pictures of the back of the castle, so I had to rely on Google Earth a little bit to get the general shape and the idea. But yeah, the backside, really struggled with that and I just wasn't really sure on what to do, so I kind of threw something together at the back there to try and make it cohesive as well. and it's okay, but I'm not really 100% happy with the back. And the sides that come off as well, I think they could have had a bit more detail in. Maybe I have to go back and just revise those a little bit, maybe. But in general, on a whole, I think the whole castle does its job and gives that illusion and the effect of being a princess castle. So I'm going to leave the footage rolling now for you to watch. If you stick around to the end, as always, I've included some screenshots of what I've done in this episode. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Please comment, like, and subscribe. If you have any questions, as always, pop them down below and I'm more than happy to answer them, whether it's to do with theme parks, the game. Just pop them down below and I'm more than happy to answer them. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye.